It's curious that I went into physics despite a total lack of enthusiasm for high school physics. I was filling out my application form for Yale, and I consulted my father, and he said, well, what are you thinking of putting down? I said, well, something connected with linguistics or something connected with archaeology. And he said, no, don't do that, you'll starve. And I said, well, what do you think I should put down? And he said, engineering. You'll be able to make a living. I said, well, I'd rather starve. He said, well, let's compromise. Why don't you major in physics? And I said, physics was an incredibly boring class in high school, and besides, I did very badly in it. It's the only subject in which I did really badly.
Well, it is a great honor to be hosting this event today, and it means a great deal to me to be 2 weeks on the job and to be essentially commemorating the contributions of someone who I've got to know is not only one of the greatest physicists of our time, but one of the greatest minds.
Thank you, Dr. Gell-Mann, for your work and your contributions to this community of thinkers who are asking the big questions and doing it right here in our community of Santa Fe.
It's been a wonderful experience to work as a theorist, where we got to know during our own lifetime whether we were right or not. It's an incredible feeling, a wonderful, wonderful feeling to have thought of a theory, to have conceived that nature would be a certain way, and to find after the experiments are done that nature is that way. It's really true.
Murray was thinking of complexity from a boy onwards, from his boyhood days onwards. If you read anything he says or if you talk with him, it was a passion of his. And in some ways, despite his extraordinary contributions to high energy physics, to the Standard Model, to supporting John and the string theory effort, he always had this passion waiting in the wings of complexity, meaning how do we understand where all this shit that is around us comes from, all the non-linear interactions, all the extraordinary phenomena that have grown on this planet Earth, where did that come from in regard to the fundamental laws of nature?
And at a certain point we were discussing a rather esoteric point about quantum mechanics, and I said something and Murray said, no. And then he put his head down on the table and went, no. I said to myself, here's someone I can work with.
A few of us had this idea, amazingly in retrospect, that there should be an institute on the landscape that works on interdisciplinary subjects, but physics being the center, that it'd be a physics-oriented institute, but it should be interdisciplinary, interfacing with many other kinds of areas. And it was kind of a wild idea. And to my amazement, when I ran into Murray someplace and talked to him, he was wildly enthusiastic.
I first met Murray at the first meeting of the MacArthur Fellowship. And there was just a handful of us. It was very strange. We had no idea what was going on. We all showed up because they said they were going to give us some money. But they picked us up in limousines with chauffeur-driven drivers, and we didn't know where we were going. We went to some mansion up on the lake, and that's where I met Murray.
Around 1999, I was asked to make a film about anything I wanted to in the world, and I said I wanted to make a film about Murray Gell-Mann. And I went to see Murray, and he immediately said yes. And that was the beginning of our friendship.
I came to understand that whenever Murray was about to reveal the truth behind a question or the beauty of an answer, that he would, you'd look at him and his eyes would glimmer and sparkle. It was as if he was living the moment the first time he came to the realization about the answer of that question. It was that sparkle that just amazed me. And I realized right then that Murray was having a not so secret romance with knowledge that he still has today.
For your contributions to physics and to me personally, thank you, Murray.
to request that each letter of my name be in 20-foot high letters. As in the Trump Tower in Chicago. And that the letters are fully lit at night. My thanks to the entire Santa Fe Institute community for this wonderful honor.